My dad is the best daddy you can have. We do everything together. We like to go fish, play golf and basketball, ride around in the country, swim in the pools and lakes, and many more things together. He is a great teacher. I started golfing at a young age because he would take me and my brother to the country club and teach us how to hit the ball. He would always say, "Keep your eye on the ball and your head down and you'll always hit it." So I did, and what do you know? I hit the ball straight. He also taught my basketball team when I was in the 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th grade. We got 2nd place in 3rd, won in the 4th grade, got 2nd again in 5th grade, and won in the 6th grade. He coached my traveling team as well, and we were good. My dad is a great cook. He loves to cook steak, pork chops, chicken, fish, and shrimp. My favorite is his tilapia and shrimp dinner. They are delicious. My dad teaches me from right from wrong. I will always thank him for that. I guess I could call him the number one dad in the world. I love him so much. Where can I start with my mom? She's great. When I was little, she would tell me to dream big and then it will come true. Mom was a great teacher, just like my dad. She would take me out to the swimming pool at the country club and throw me in the pool when I was just a baby. She said, if you put a kid in the water when they're young, then they'll become great swimmers. Well, she's right. I've been swimming on the swim team my whole life. We love to soak up the sun at the swimming pool. She also took me to the country club to play golf. She wanted me to grow up and become a golfer. She taught me how to also keep my head down and eye on the ball. My mom always has a positive attitude. If I don't do good on a test or homework, she'll tell me to keep my head up and try a little bit better next time. My mom wants me to have a successful life. She wants me to go to college and become a great person to everyone. She tells me to always put God first, then others, then myself. I always will, and I always will love her. My grandma is not your typical grandma. Let's just say she is 66 going on 16. She acts so crazy 24/7. We don't even call her grandma or a nanny or anything like that. We call her by her name, and that's Jerry Lee. She is one person who I would go to for everything. We could talk all night and never run out of things to talk about. All my friends love her. I'll probably have to say she spoils me, my brother, and my little cousins. She is the one person I'll go shopping with. But she can't help it. That's what grandparents do. She's very creative. I believe she has made over 30 or so scrapbooks. I went with her to a scrapbook convention, and all the women were working hard. I could not keep up. I call her the scrapbooking queen. She absolutely loves Elvis Presley. She always keeps a camera on her. She takes more pictures than anyone I know. But that's why I love her to death. I don't know what I'll do if I lost her. Cat peeping in the seafood store. Well, I can look at you, tell you ain't no child no more. My brother Harris is the best brother you can ask for. We are 3 years apart, and I think that is perfect time period for siblings. When I was a little freshman in high school, he was the big man on campus, a senior. I always look up to him because I knew he would look after me since I was his little sis. When I was in a relationship, he would always be protected over me because he didn't want me to be hurt. I always will thank him for that. We enjoy the same things. We love to play golf. We were both on the golf team. He tries to help me out with my golf swing, but I usually go back to my mom and dad for that kind of stuff. We also swim on the swim team together. I would say I was faster than him, but he will probably argue about it because he couldn't say a girl, even his sister, was faster than he was. When we're little, like every sibling, we will fight. But now, since we are older and mature, we don't anymore, and I like that. That's a few reasons why I love my brother Harris. Reminds me of you and me, baby, do you?
drive you home. No, I don't mind.
Sarah Fuller is my best friend. We were friends even before we knew each other. My dad was the one who introduced her parents to each other. But thank goodness he did, or I would not have a friend like her. We grew up with each other. We spent the night at each other's house probably every night of the summer. When we were little, we were on the swim team and basketball team, and we danced for Kristen Hickman. Now we play golf on our high school golf team. We go to the same church and is involved in a youth group. Every time we are out in public together, there is at least one person who asks if we are either twins or cousins, or we just get stared at because people think we are. We usually say no, we aren't even kin, but sometimes we trick them and say we are sisters. During fall break, my family, her family, and another family go to Destin, Florida every year. We have a blast. Sarah and I tell each other everything when it comes to boys, gossip, or anything, you name it. We love to ride around in the country and jam to Taylor Swift or Miley Cyrus. She's the best friend I could ever ask for. I wouldn't trade her for anything. I love her like a sister.